John, you set your sights on the future. You co-founded Pixar, which sparked nothing less than a revolution in the art of animated feature filmmaking.
Animators make the best directors. And that's the reason why John Lasseter is so damn good at what he does. And why Pixar is so successful. And that's why he came back to Disney.
John Lasseter's leadership in computer animation took it from its infancy and revolutionized the animation and film industries. John's passion for storytelling and his tireless dedication and work led to his lasting legacy. Computer animation might not have reached the level of advancement we have today without John Lasseter.
In order to talk about 3D animation, we need to tell you a little bit about 2D animation. Several key advancements in film and motion pictures occurred. Thomas Edison created the kinetoscope in 1889, which could project in 13 seconds 50 feet of film. In the same year, photographic film strips were starting to be manufactured. Humorous Phases of Funny Faces, made by John Stuart Blackton in 1906, was the first animated film created by filming a drawn face, stopping the camera, erasing the face, drawing a new one, and filming again. In 1908, Phantasmagoria was the first animation which used a black background with white figures, while in 1914, the Animation Cell, a clear celluloid sheet with a hand-drawn picture that gets photographed with the background and used with subsequent hand-drawn pictures, was invented and used by Earl Hurd. Walt Disney Studios was established in 1923 and produces the first hand-drawn animation with sound called Steamboat Willie in 1928. By 1937, Disney released in theaters the first ever full-length animated feature film, Snow White. 40 years later, in 1977, Lucasfilm's Industrial Light and Magic gave film an interesting boost by using computer-generated imaging in their blockbuster hit, Star Wars. By 1982, Disney used computer imaging in their movie, Tron.
Meanwhile, on January 12, 1957, John Lasseter was born in Hollywood, California. When John was growing up, he had a love for cartoons, and he saw every Disney cartoon that he could. As a five-year-old, he won his first award of $15 from the Model Grocery Market in Whittier, California, for a crayon drawing of the Headless Horseman. When he was in high school, he read a book called The Art of Animation by Bob Thomas, and it dawned on him that people do animation for a living. John had been inspired by great cartoons Walt Disney created, such as Snow White, and his favorite, Dumbo. He once said, "Even though you couldn't get me out of bed on a weekday, come Saturday morning, I was up at 6:30 a.m. to watch cartoons." While in his senior year in high school, John Lasseter became the second student to be accepted into Disney's new animation program at the California Institute of the Arts, also known as CalArts. He graduated with a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Film in 1979. During his time at CalArts, he was the only two-time winner of the Student Academy Award for Animation for his student films of Lady in the Lamp and Nightmare. During the summer, John worked as an apprentice at Disney Studios, along with his college roommate, Michael Cedino. They were the only students to turn their line drawing projects into fully animated shorts.
John and I changed the history of CalArts because we did films. We didn't do animation pencil tests. We put sound on it and music on it and credits on it. And then so we had standing ovations.
Which changed and shaped the CalArts curriculum. CalArts learning environment was different from other art schools at the time, which allowed for the creative process to flow.
1982 marked John Lasseter's first exposure to computer animation with the production of Disney science fiction movie Tron. In February of 1983, Lasseter and a group of Disney animators took a tour of the Lucasfilm Computer Animation Division. Ed Catmull, head of the LCAD, saw Lasseter's curiosity and excitement by the possibilities of their computer graphics software advancements. Lasseter was envisioning the potential of what computer-generated animation could do for 2D hand-drawn animation. John had the idea of using computer-generated backgrounds with 2D hand-drawn characters inside those backgrounds. John thought to himself, this is what Walt was waiting for. Lasseter pitched to Disney his film idea called The Brave Little Toaster, in which 2D hand-drawn characters would move on a 3D computer-generated background. Disney Studios rejected his idea and fired him that very day, because Disney did not want anything to do with computers unless it made their work faster and cheaper. In reality, Disney Studios was not ready to change their status quo. Ironically, Ed Catmull offered John a job at the Lucasfilm Computer Animation Division just after being fired from Disney. The LCAD was on the cutting edge of using new technology. Soon thereafter, the LCAD was bought by Steve Jobs and renamed Pixar.
Pixar started by doing computer animated television commercials. They also did computer animated shorts. Their first and most significant short was called Adventures of Andre and Wally B. This amazed the SIGGRAPH conference audience in 1984. SIGGRAPH stands for Special Interest Group on Computer Graphics and Interactive Techniques. Never before had they watched computer-generated images flow so smoothly, tell story, and have characters in the way John had created in his short for the SIGGRAPH conference. In 1995, Pixar released under John Lasseter's leadership, Toy Story, the first ever full-length computer-animated feature film. Toy Story was a hit, and John won a Special Achievement Academy Award for his development and application of techniques. Toy Story made $191.8 million, when Disney hand-drawn Pocahontas only made $141 million that same year. Lasseter's talent for storytelling and his vision for what computers could do to make his stories come to life propelled Pixar to success. John and his team of animators pushed the envelope of computer programming in order to achieve realistic skin textures and lifelike fur on their characters.
Disney regretted the decision of firing John Lasseter and wanted him back. Disney, at first, thought they were being true to Walt Disney's vision and tried to keep doing things exactly the same. They soon realized they would need to change to keep his dream alive. Disney movies were declining in box office sales, yet Pixar movies, led by John Lasseter, were blockbuster hits and winning awards. Eventually, Disney decided to buy Pixar. Before Disney bought Pixar, they had an agreement for Pixar to make computer animated movies for Disney. In 2006, Disney officially acquired Pixar and made John the chief creative officer of Walt Disney Feature Animation.
It was very important for me when Bob Iger and Steve Jobs agreed to let Disney buy Pixar and merge the two companies. Then they asked me to become chief creative officer of Disney Animation, as well as continue doing that with Pixar Animation.
Disney shareholders gave him a standing ovation and declared that he was the savior of the entire company. With the acquisition of Pixar and John Lasseter, Disney started making hit movies again, and sales for both companies increased. Disney even started making computer animated movies under John Lasseter's leadership.
John's management style was very open door to all staff. There were a lot of hurdles to overcome when taking over as chief creative officer. He had to change long-standing practices of current employees to get them to open up to accepting new ideas and procedures. His office had glass walls so the staff could see him and he could see them. Disney had a very stifling environment and old employees clung to old ways, whereas John encouraged his staff and helped them grow and succeed. Not everyone has agreed that John is a great leader. While Brenda Chapman was directing Brave, she was removed from the project by John for conflicting points of view. Chapman then publicly accuses John of micromanagement. Chapman claims, at Pixar, it's all John's show. However, most everyone felt the environment Lasseter created allowed ideas to flow and allowed for better movies with better stories.
Thanks to John Lasseter's vision to modify and change the field of animation by using computer imaging technology and refining it, we now have the technology capable of creating movies like Cars and Toy Story, both of which have brought enjoyment to millions of people. If he had not been so adamant about computer graphics and willing to pursue his dreams and lead the animation industry into the future, we would not have the movies we love and enjoy today. John Lasseter has affected the film industry, the animation industry, and computer animation itself.
John Lasseter's legacy is not done.